Ryan, there's something that I have to tell you. I was born in 1931. Oh, no, I've never lied to you. I am 23. But I've been 23 since 1954. I know. I know it's impossible, right? No one lives forever, but sometimes they do. In 1953, I got married. A few weeks after my wedding, I grew ill. My husband took me to the hospital, and I was there for almost a week, and no one knew for sure what was wrong with me. The one night at the hospital, a stranger came to see me. He told me, "Janie, you're gonna die tomorrow." The name that I used then, the name that I was born with. He said, "Either you can die tomorrow or live forever. Stay young forever." My point that I'm making is that this man offered me a chance to live, and I took it. I will live forever, and I will never age. My husband died of a car accident at 45. And at his funeral, the stranger came to see me again, and he asked me if I wanted to give up my gift and die. I thought about it, but I told him no, I wasn't ready. I have centuries and centuries ahead of me. I'm looking for someone to love forever. I mean, most people, when they say forever, they don't actually mean forever. I love you, Ryan. And I'm asking you to share forever with me. Ryan, there is something I have to tell you. I was born in 1931. No! No, I've never lied to you. I am 23, but I've been 23 since 1954. I know. It's impossible, right? No one can live forever, but sometimes they do. In 1953, I got married. And a few weeks after the wedding, I fell ill. My husband, you know, took me to the hospital, and I was there for like a week, and no one knew for sure what was wrong with me. At the hospital, this stranger came to see me. He told me, "Janie, you're gonna die tomorrow." That's the name that I used and the name that I was born with. So he said, "You know, either you can die tomorrow or live forever, stay young forever." My point that I'm making is that I was offered a chance to live and I took it. I will live forever and I would never age. Well, my husband died of a car accident, and at this funeral, the stranger came to see me again, and he asked me, "Do I want to give up my gift and die?" I mean, yeah, I thought about it, but I told him, "No, I'm not ready. I have centuries and centuries ahead of me." But, you know, I am looking for someone to love forever. You know what most people say forever, they don't actually mean forever, but I do. I love you, Ryan. And I'm asking you to share forever with me.